if I gave you commitment today?
Supposing I said, yeah, I could do 30, what would happen?
We'd get the contract sent over right now. We'd get it locked down. I'm really interested. Yeah.
So you have 30 today, and you could do it today, right?
I'm liquid. I could do it right now, right here. Yep. If you give me that great deal, I think it's a really good property, and awesome. I'm going for it.
Awesome. So let's do that. Let's go ahead and send me your. I'll send you my information. You can send me your information, and then we'll just close the deal.
Okay.
Right now.
Sounds good. Doesn't have to be hard, right?
Doesn't have to be hard. How are you getting paid, Luke? By the way, now that the phone call role play is over, how and when are you getting paid? How's the money being transferred to you? And is she sending it to you today? I didn't quite hear that part. Did anyone else? Back in the role play, just to clean it up. You did great. You did great. But this is why we call it Role Play Wednesday. The more we practice, is how we learn. These are the things we have to think. It's hard to think about all this stuff. You're in the middle of a negotiation. It's real serious. You're talking about a lot of money. Do we get a little nervous or self-conscious? I do.
Yeah.
And the only way to do, I remember Claude talked about this. I need to talk about the money and how I'm going to get the money and what means she's going to use and everything. Yeah. You did qualify her. She did say she has the money. I just didn't hear the specific payment. Back in the role play, Jessica and me. Jessica, I'm so glad we're doing business. You're going to make a fortune. You're going to make it. What you're paying back to me, you're going to get that back and more just in the first year. And there's an equity in the property already, and it's a great neighborhood. It'll probably double in value over the next couple of years. The $30,000, did you want to do that on a credit card or a wire transfer today? What would be comfortable for you, ma'am?
Yeah, I'll send you my proof of funds, and we can set up a wire, get it right over to you.
Okay, and you could send that at what, 3 o'clock, 4 o'clock?
Yeah, 3 p.m. today. Oh. Well, I think wire cutoff is about 2 o'clock in the afternoon, so I'll have it to you over by then.
Okay. Oh, you're wonderful. I love doing business with you. Thank you so much.
I love your get it done kind of attitude, you know?
That's the way, and I'm really good at finding deals, and I'm sure we'll do many other deals in the future. And we came to this decision very fast. And are you comfortable? I don't want you to get off the phone and start worrying or anything. You sound to me like a serious business person.
I've done a few deals now, so I'm, kind of used to it, and I know what I'm looking for. And when I see it, I just launch right in there, and
I love doing business with you. You're old school. You know how to make commitments and keep them. I love doing business with you. Boom. Yeah. What did I just do? That's called schmoozing in New York City. Okay. What am I doing? Was that the super stroke or nurturing?
Definitely.
Why is that so important at the end of the deal? Most people, what do they do when they get a deal and they get excited and everything? Oh, she's going to send me money. And they go click. What can happen?
Cold feet.
Cold feet? Can she change her mind? Oh, why did I say that? Oh, I could have got a better deal. Oh, maybe I should have spoke to my fiance or Snow White or somebody. Hello, Lou. Lou, I hate to do this to you, but I changed my mind, okay? Lou told his wife, Lou put a down payment on a new Cadillac. Lou spent that money mentally in his head, didn't he?
Oh, no.
Oh, no. Okay, I have to go. Was this fun? Did we learn anything today?
Yes.
Yeah.
Lou, I put you on the hot seat, but you did great. I'm sorry, Val.
Thank you. That was wonderful.
You're welcome.
That was awesome. Thank you.
Show us your pretty face next time, Valerie. Come on that. I especially comb my hair for you.
That was awesome. Claude, thank you.
You're welcome. Remember the takeaway from today. People love to engage, but they will not initiate the conversation. If you want to make a lot of money in real estate or anything else in sales, you have to initiate the conversation. Even if you face possible embarrassment of rejection. But most people when you go to them, oh, I love your dog. What a beautiful child. Oh, your house is gorgeous. Oh my gosh. How long have you, you must have put a lot of work into your garden. When you speak to people the right way, how hard is it to engage them?
Easy.
It's easy. And when you engage people, the forces of the universe are in your favor to make money, get a commitment, or at least have a pleasant conversation without the rejection that everybody else gets. Is this important?
Can I, Claude, can I ask you a question?
Real quick, I'm late. I got to leave.
Okay.